السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: رب صائم ليس له من صيامه إلا الجوع، ورب قائم ليس له من قيامه إلا السهر، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. صدق الله المولانا العظيم، وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. We begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, the most magnificent, our Lord, our Creator, our Sustainer, our Nourisher. And we bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and messenger. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, none can misguide him. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, none can guide him. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from shaitan the accursed and from the evils of our own souls. When the month of Sha'ban would come to an end, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gathered the Sahaba and gave them a prep talk in regards to Ramadan. And I just wanted to read through that prep talk to see what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the Sahaba, what he had to say in regards to the preparation of Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith reported by Salman al-Farisi radiallahu anhu, Ibn Khuzaymah rahimahullah mentions it in his book of Sahih Hadith. He says, when the month of Ramadan would come close, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gathered us. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya ayyuha al-nas, qad adallakum shahrun azeemun mubarakun. O people, verily a great blessed month has come over us. Shahrun fihi laylatun khayrun min alfi shahr. This is a month wherein there is a night which is better than 1,000 nights. And now the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam obviously indicating towards Laylatul Qadr. شَهْرٌ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ صِيَامَهُ فَرِيضَةً وَقِيَامَ لَيْلِهِ تَتَوُّعًا. It is a month in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made fasting fard upon us, and standing the night prayer an optional and rewarded act. مَنْ تَقَرَّبَ فِيهِ بِخَصْلَةٍ مِّنَ الْخَيْرِ كَانَ كَمَنْ أَدَّى فَرِيضَةً فِيمَا سِوَاهُ. We know that in the month of Ramadan, our actions are multiplied. The rewards of our action are multiplied multifold. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if we involve ourselves in any action of khayr, a good action, optional action which isn't fard, through the fadl and the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are given the reward as if we have performed an obligatory act. And if we have to perform an obligatory act, وَمَنْ أَدَّى فَرِيضَةً فِيهِ كَانَ كَمَنْ أَدَّى سَبْعِينَ فَرِيضَةً فِيمَا سِوَاهُ. If we perform something that's obligatory, the fasting, the praying, things that are fard upon us already, through the fadl, the grace, the mercy, the rahmah, the compassion, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't reward us with one completed obligatory act, but 70 completed obligatory acts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the reward of 70. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continued and said, وَهُوَ شَهْرُ الصَّبْرِ. It is a month of patience. Obviously, we're staying away from our desires, from food, from drink, from anything that may be displeasing to Allah. It's a month of sabr. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained what's the reward of sabr. We go through the whole month of Ramadan. We are patient with ourselves, our bodies, physically, spiritually. We're going through a lot of, it's an intense spiritual month. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَالصَّبْرُ ثَوَابُهُ الْجَنَّةِ. What's the reward of all this patience? صبر ثوابه الجنة. The reward of patience is Jannah. So if we go through this month of Ramadan with patience and staying away from anything which is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our reward inshaAllah with the fadl and grace and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be none other than Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continued and told the Sahaba, وَهُوَ شَهْرُ الْمُؤَاسَاتِ. The month of Ramadan is a month of giving, a month of charity, a month of love, a month of compassion. It's a month of sharing with others those that may not have as much as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. It's a month that we share it with other people. وَشَهْرٌ يُزَادُ فِيهِ رِزْقِ الْمُؤْمِنِ فِيهِ. It's a month wherein the risk, the provision, the sustenance of a believer is increased. مَنْ فَطَّرَ فِيهِ صَائِمًا كَانَ مَغْفِرَةً لِذُنُوبِهِ وَعِتْقُ رَقَبَتِهِ مِنَ النَّارِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if you feed a person, a fasting person, if you help a fasting person break his fast, كَانَ مَغْفِرَةً لِذُنُوبِهِ. By you helping him break his fast, giving him some food to eat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving your sins. وَعِتْقُ رَقَبَتِهِ مِنَ النَّارِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is freeing you from the fire of Jahannam. It reminds me last week, alhamdulillah, I mean, I meet such amazing people sometimes. You know, externally they look just like a normal brother or a normal sister, but within them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them so much beauty. And you know, through their actions, it just amazes me. So the brother, he came to pick up a box of dates. And while picking up a box of dates, he picked up two. And I know he has a small family. So I said to the brother, subhanAllah, maybe you eat a lot of dates. You know, maybe it's the month of Ramadan. Maybe you overdo it with the dates. Why two boxes? And he said, no, I buy one box for myself and one box for a family I know that can't afford it. And it's something that I learned from my father, and it's something that I've continued to do for many, many years. And so I thought to myself, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you help someone break their fast and it's a means of forgiveness of your sins. You help someone break their fast and it's freedom from the fire of Jahannam. For your own sins, for yourself, you're freeing yourself from the fire of Jahannam. Hence I thought to myself, what an amazing transaction. He's paying some money for a box of dates, and that family that can afford the box of dates will break their fast with the box of dates that he's given them, hence so much reward. And subhanAllah, something that I never even thought of before, but such an amazing way that a person can give and take in so much reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was then asked by the Sahaba, O Prophet of Allah, not all of us can give other people, not all of us have enough for ourselves. How can we provide food for other people to break their fast? And, you know, not all of us can afford, you know, huge iftar parties and inviting hundreds of people or sponsoring an iftar. Not everyone can do it. So the Sahaba, they asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what if we can't do everything? What if we can't afford so much? And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, يُعْتِ اللَّهُ هَذَا الثَّوَابَ مَنْ فَطَّرَ صَائِمًا مَذْقَةَ لَبَنٍ أَوْ عَلَى تَمْرَةٍ أَوْ شَرْبَةِ مَاءٍ. You don't need to have a 5-course meal to help them break their fast. If it's just a date, if it's just a sip of water, if it's just a sip of milk that you can afford and give to someone else, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the same reward. What's the reward? For getting our sins forgiven and freeing ourselves from the fire of Jahannam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then went on and encouraged the Sahaba more. And said, وَمَنْ أَشْبَعَ صَائِمًا سَقَاهُ اللَّهُ مِنْ حَوْضِي شُرْبَةً لَا يَضْمَأُ حَتَّى يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةِ. If you give water to a fasting person to break their fast with that water, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the opportunity to drink from the hawd of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of Qiyamah. Such water, we know from the hawd of Kawthar, the pond of Kawthar, that a person will never feel thirsty after that ever again. وَهُوَ شَهْرٌ أَوَّلَهُ رَحْمَةً. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continued and said, the beginning of this month is full of mercy. It's all about the mercy, the compassion, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, when a child, a grown man, stays away from his parents for months on end, maybe he doesn't call them, maybe he's upset at them, maybe something's happened between the family, but then all of a sudden he shows up at the parents' door. When the parents open that door, even though it's been months of not talking to your own child, maybe it's been months of anger, maybe it's been months of family feud, whatever it may be, The minute the son arrives at home, right? أوله رحمة. It's the rahmah of the parents that take over the child's life. It's the rahmah of the parents that take the child into the house. Even though it's been months that the son hasn't called, but just seeing the son there, the rahmah overtakes the whole situation. It's been a whole year and we've been far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we haven't recited the Qur'an we haven't fasted the way we should have fasted. We haven't read the Qur'an or remembered Allah the way we should have remembered Allah. But it's the month of Ramadan, we've arrived at the doorstep of Allah. أَوَّلُهُ رَحْمَةً. The first 10 days are all about the mercy and the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَوْسَطُهُ مَغْفِرَةً. The second 10 days of Ramadan are all about the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَآخِرُهُ عِتْقٌ مِنَ النَّارِ. And the last 10 days are all about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala freeing us from the fire of Jahannam. This was the prep talk that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave to the Sahaba in regards to the month of Ramadan. For us, it's important to remember, as we fast, we're not fasting just from food and drink and from relationship with our spouses, but we are fasting from anything and everything that may be displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ صِيَامِهِ إِلَّا الْجُوعِ. There are some people that fast from sunup to sundown without any food, without any drink, without any relationship with their spouses. But what do they get out of their fast? Absolutely nothing, except for the fact that they stayed hungry. Except for the fact that they stayed thirsty. That's the physical part. You're staying away from food and drink. But there's a spiritual part as well. Staying away from anything and everything that's displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let it not be that we are from amongst those that fast, but the only thing we get from our fast is hunger. Let it be that through our fast we become closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَرُبَّ قَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ قِيَامِهِ إِلَّا السَّهْوُ. There are some people that stand long in prayer at night, but they get absolutely nothing from their prayer at night, except for the fact that they're staying up at night, except for the fact that they're losing their sleep. So everything, there's a physical aspect, there's a spiritual aspect as well. We're not doing it just because we were born into a Muslim family, or just because it's custom or tradition, or if I don't fast, or if I don't pray, what do people say of me? We are doing it for the sake of Allah. We are doing it to please Allah. We are doing it so that we can erase our sins and get on the good side with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Need to protect our hearts as well. Ulama say that there are four ways to the heart. And these four ways to the heart directly affect the way our heart is, our spiritual heart. Those four ways are through what we see, through what we hear, through what we think about, and through what we speak about. If we control these four channels to our heart, then our heart will be protected as well. Through what we see, to make sure what we see is only that which is halal. To abstain from looking at anything that is haram. Through what we hear directly affects us. If on the way to work I listen to a radio talk show, then when I get to work, all I'm thinking about is what I listen to at work, on the way to work. If I listen to Quran, it will directly affect me. If I listen to hadith, it will directly affect me. If I listen to backbiting and gossip, then it will directly affect me. It's something that's directly affecting our heart. Thirdly, something that directly affects our heart is what we think about. What we think about directly affects the way we think, the way we act, our behaviors. In CBT, in cognitive behavioral therapy, they talk about this all the time. That our thinking is what affects our emotions. And our emotions is what affects our behavior. And so even in regards to Sawm, sometimes we think, you know, we become pessimistic and we think it's so hard. You know, we're fasting all day, it's a very long fast. And then our nafs is telling us, oh, it's so long, it's 80 degrees today, it's this, it's that. So we have this pessimistic thinking that will directly affect our emotions and affect our behavior. So even if you woke up from a long sleep, because you've been thinking negative about fasting and about the hot weather, when you wake up, you'll automatically be in a very pessimistic, lethargic mood. So for us to be positive about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, it's amazing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions fasting, mentions Ramadan, and then says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرِ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants easiness for you, not hardship. Hence you'll find in the month of Ramadan, it's easier to fast. 16 hours we're fasting, 15 hours we're fasting, yet alhamdulillah, we're getting through it. The month of the winter come, right? Think of it now, we're fasting 16 hours, it's not that hard. And then now if you think about it, when the winter comes, it's only 8, 10 hours, maybe 12. Think maybe it'll be easier to fast in the winter. But when the winter comes along, we don't even think about fasting. Right? We don't even think about, hey, let me do an optional fast here or there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easier in the month of Ramadan for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fills our days with barakah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fills our nights with barakah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us energy that we couldn't find throughout the whole year. Why? Because it's the month of Ramadan. Right? It's a different story if you overeat and you can't stand up. But you know, if you moderately eat and moderately sleep, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us so much barakah in the month of Ramadan, and it's all about the way we think. So if we correct the way we think, and think instead of thinking, oh, it's a long fast, and it's a hot day, and oh my God, we have to stay for Taraweeh, and oh my God, it's such a long day. No, instead of all of this thinking, think positively. Think, alhamdulillah, Allah's given me the opportunity of Ramadan. Think, alhamdulillah, through my fasting, my du'as are accepted. Think, alhamdulillah, through this fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving my sins and entering me into Jannah and saving me from the fire of Jahannam. Then with the positive thinking, you'll wake up with more energy than you had throughout the whole year. Why? Because of the way we think. So like I was mentioning, the way we think, it directly affects our heart as well. And fourthly, what we speak about directly affects our heart. So if we guard these things throughout our fast, guard our sight, guard what we hear, guard what we speak about. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, مَا يَلْفِذُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. There are ahadith and ayat of Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us about in regards to our speech. Once the Sahaba were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, مَا أَخْوَفُ عَلَيْكَ. O Prophet of Allah, what's the thing you fear most about your ummah? What's the thing you fear most about your ummah? What's that fitna? You know, is it wealth? Is it women? Is it this? Is it... What's the thing you fear most for us, O Prophet of Allah? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam grabbed his tongue. أَخَذَ بِلِسَانِ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam grabbed his tongue and said, the thing I fear most about my ummah is their use of speech. Right? How we use our speech, whether there's vulgarity, whether there's backbiting, whether we're lying, whether we're gossiping, if we protect our speech, then we're protecting our hearts. So the four channels to the heart, through what we see, through what we hear, through what we speak, and through what we think about, if we protect these four channels, direct highways to our heart, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also, inshallah, protect our heart from anything that is, you know, that may be spiritually disastrous for our Ramadan. Also in this month of Ramadan, I mentioned this last night and I'll mention it again, inshallah. In this month of Ramadan, it's a month of making dua, a month of connecting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the same area in Surah Al-Baqarah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions fasting and mentions Ramadan and mentions the Quran and mentions how to fast, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions the connection that we as human beings have in making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. The beauty of this ayah is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attributes everything to Himself. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attributes things to Himself, personally, using personal pronouns, it indicates one of two things. Either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is extremely happy, or either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is extremely angry. And so in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using personal pronouns and attributing everything to Himself. Why? Because it's of His extreme rahmah, His love, His mercy. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي. When my servant asks of me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have said, when a servant asks of me. Or when the slave asks of me. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when my slave asks of me. فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Then verily I am very near. Verily I am very near. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانْ. I am the one that accepts the call or the one that fulfills the call of the one who makes dua. And it's not, you know, the beauty of the word as well, and I mentioned this last night, I'll mention it again. دَعْوَةُ الدَّاعِ literally means a person that makes dua even once. In the Arabic language, da'wa is masdar marra, which means something that happens just once. Akala means to eat. If you say aklatun, it means just one morsel of food or one meal. Darbatun means to hit. Daraba means to hit. But if you say darbatun, it's just one hit. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says da'watu da'i. Da'watun, even one dua. Throughout the year, if we haven't made a sincere dua and we lift our hands even once in this month of Ramadan with sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even the person that makes dua once, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ujibu da'wat al-da'i idha da'an. When he calls me and when he makes that call, the call of the caller, Ujibu da'wat al-da'i, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am the one that accepts the dua of that person. So in this month of Ramadan, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the fasting person's dua is accepted until he breaks his fast. We have this opportunity in the month of Ramadan. From the sun up to sundown, we are fasting. It's a time of rahmah, a time of acceptance of dua. Something that can make it easier for us, and something that I've practiced for many years now. Many times we have many dua that we want to make. So we want to make dua for our children, want to make dua for a better job, for a raise, want to make dua for a nice house, make dua for Jannah, make dua. We have so many things that we could make dua for. But when you raise your hands, it's just one of those things. You forget exactly what you wanted to make dua for. Or all those things that you had listed or you thought that I would make dua for. Write down a list. And make a list of du'as, make a list of people you want to make du'a for, a list of things that you want to make du'a for. Leave it on your phone, leave it with you in a piece of paper in your pocket. And when you raise your hands, just remind yourself the things you want to make du'a for. It's a month of du'a, a month of prayer, something that will help us throughout our lives. And so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this month of Ramadan a month of mercy, a month of barakah, a month of forgiveness, a month of saving ourselves from the fire of Jahannam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to end this blessed month to forgive our sins, to cleanse our hearts, and to keep us and our families away from all harm. Before I end, inshallah, just some announcements in regards to the Ramadan programs. Firstly, in regards to Taraweeh Salah, alhamdulillah, we've been blessed with Hafiz Ahmed Saeed Chaudhry, who is a Hafiz of Quran, was born and raised in Saudi Arabia and completed his Hifz in Saudi Arabia as well. He's leading the Taraweeh Salah for us, inshallah, this year. So obviously the Taraweeh Salah after the Isha Salah, which is at 10:15, everyone's requested to join, inshallah. Secondly, also there after the 8 Raka'ah, there's a short break, we have a short talk. And after the Fajr Salah as well, there's a short talk just going over some ahadith, just the daily reminder, inspiration, encouragement for the month of Ramadan. That's daily after Fajr as well. Thirdly, community iftar dinners, inshallah. Like always, we'll have community iftar dinners on the weekends, Saturdays and Sundays. These iftar dinners are sponsored by community members. Remember, we mentioned all the rewards of helping people break their fast. Amazing opportunity for anyone and everyone that can afford it, inshallah. If you're interested in sponsoring iftar, you can talk to members of the management, inshallah. Also, we will have i'tikaf in the masjid in the last 10 days. If you have intention to have i'tikaf in the last, to spend time in i'tikaf in the last 10 days, also please mention this to the masjid management. And lastly, there are dates that are available for anyone that doesn't have or needs date boxes, inshallah. We still have a few boxes left there in the back. Lastly, today there is a janazah at 2:15 in the cemetery here in Danbury. So about 2:15 or 2:30, inshallah, there will be a janazah. We make dua for the sister that passed away in this blessed month. We make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her. We make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give her the highest ranks in Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make her akhirah easy for her. We make dua for all the Muslimin that have passed away, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive them and grant them Jannah al-Firdaus. Jazakumullahu khair.